Hi everyone, I'm Mike Trosel, and we continue to look at golf across America by highlighting Oklahoma, the Sooner State. Tulsa's Southern Hills Country Club has hosted 9 USGA championships, including the 1953 U.S. Junior Amateur, and that was Jack Nicklaus's first of 68 USGA championships that he played in. It's also home to Scott Verplank. Scott's about 2 hours west of Tulsa in Edmond, Oklahoma, just north of Oklahoma City. Scott, the 1984 U.S. Amateur Champion, and won 5 times in the PGA Tour. Welcome in.
Thanks, Mike. Nice to be here.
Now, Scott, you grew up in the Dallas area, but then moved to Oklahoma a little bit later in life. Now, can you tell us about your time at Oklahoma State University, a little bit about the golf program there, the storied golf program there, and your experience there?
Yeah, that's the reason that I ended up in Oklahoma, honestly, is I determined that Oklahoma State was going to be the best place for me to play golf. Obviously, I wanted to try to play on the tour, and it just had... It had more of the things that I needed to propel me into the future. So that's how I ended up here. I played on great teams. I kind of wanted to play against the best players every single day. So that's one reason. That's the main reason I went to Oklahoma State. You know, qualifying was tough because you had to beat the best players in the country just to get on the team. I liked it. I love Dallas, but I. But after living in Stillwater, which is about 40,000 versus Dallas, which is about 40 million, I was like, you know, that's not so bad. I don't have to sit in traffic and all that. So I found a great place where I'm at. Been here a long time.
And now during your time at Oklahoma State, you won the 1984 U.S. Amateur just up the road, less than an hour away from Stillwater at Oak Tree National. Can you tell us about that experience there and how it was like to win the Havemeyer Trophy less than an hour away from your college campus?
Well, it was pretty interesting because I'd never played Oak Tree in the summer before. So actually, the golf course was so hard, I hated it. I mean, we'd go down and qualify in college, but it would always be on a day that was about 45 degrees and the wind blowing about 20. So, I mean, if you broke 80, you played great. So I really didn't even like the golf course. I mean, it was just, I liked it, but I didn't like playing it because it was so dang hard. But then we got to play it in the summer, and all of a sudden I was like, hey, I can play this place. And, you know, whatever. One thing led to another, and I ended up winning the U.S. Amateur. And ultimately, I actually live on the 16th hole of that golf course right now. So it's been a great community, and the U.S. Amateur kind of led me to where a great place that I've had my wife and I have raised our kids and made a home.
I want to pick up on that. So after graduation, you decided to stay in Edmond. You know, what makes that area great to raise a family and also a really special, unique place for a golf area with the Oak Tree Gang?
Yeah, that's kind of the initial attraction was, you know, it was a landmark property. It was the original landmark property, if you know what landmark golf was. And they had the Oak Tree logo, and the original Oak Tree is on the 5th hole at this golf course. But just had a bunch of guys that played the tour, a bunch of guys that either played at Oklahoma State or like as Dr. Gil Morgan, he just grew up around here. He didn't play at Oklahoma State, but he grew up around here. And just the community, it was all a big Oak Tree community. It's a little broken up now, but Oak Tree National is the golf course I live on, and it's the golf course that all the guys that play tour golf play on. We actually have a bunch of young guys now that are web players and young guys on the regular tour now that actually still hang around here. You know, as long as you can get out of here when the weather is really bad for about 6 weeks a year, then the rest of the time is great.
Now, what makes playing golf in Oklahoma as a state in general really unique, whether that's the courses or the weather conditions that challenge you guys out there?
It's obviously the weather conditions. That was one, that's one, it sounds weird, but that's one benefit to going to Oklahoma State or even OU, who won the national championship a couple of years ago. I mean, you're going to end up being an all-around player because you're going to play in every weather condition, every kind of wind. Your 4 years in college, or however many years you spend, you're going to see it all, and so that's actually a good experience. I mean, I think it'd be great to spend 4 years in perfect weather all the time, but I don't know how good that prepares you because after playing professional golf for 33 years,
it's not always perfect. And a lot of times you have to, you know, you gotta suck it up, and having some experience at that obviously helps.
And finally, Scott, you're a type 1 diabetic, and you've used an insulin pump during competition throughout your career. You know, how has diabetes affected your career, and what are you doing with your foundation now to help some students and younger adults with their coping with the disease?
Well, I've been type 1 diabetic for 45 years. It obviously affects you every single day. I mean, the first thing I think about when I wake up is I gotta get my body right. So that's more important than, you know, swinging good or putting good or anything else. That's really the only that's the only thing that matters originally. But it affects me. But I was a little kid, decided I was going to play golf for a living. When I wasn't big enough to play football, I figured I better go play golf. I've had to overcome it, but it hadn't hindered me as much as obviously as much as it might other people. But as far as my foundation, my wife and I've always wanted to do something, and everybody, not a knock on anybody, but everybody for every deal is always trying to find a cure for everything, for diabetes, cancer, heart disease, everything you can think of. And that's great. And I've spent time with different organizations, raising money, finding a cure or cures. And finally, I wanted something that was tangible. So we ultimately got together with some friends of mine, and it cost about $10,000 a year to be a type 1 diabetic if you have good insurance. So I kind of got formulated this idea that we'd start giving out $10,000 a year scholarships to type 1 kids who play a sport, try hard in school, and try to take care of themselves. Those are the three prerequisites. And it's gone great. We've actually had so much interest that we actually have had to break our scholarships down some, because there's so many more people applying and so many more kids and families that need and appreciate the help. But I think right now we have 39 kids in college that are on a scholarship from our foundation. So I like that. It's pretty cool. And I've learned a lot, and the kids have just been spectacular.
Sounds like very rewarding work. And Scott, we know you just had some wrist surgery, so looking forward to seeing you back out on the PGA Tour Champions very soon, and hopefully at the U.S. Senior Open this year. And thank you very much for giving us some insight on Oklahoma as we continue to celebrate 125 years of golf history.